centered position.
Origin of the
origin.
Center of the
origin
of the center. It's okay. Or origin of the origin.
So we want to check. Sharpener, and anyone's got a sharpener?
Yes.
Okay. Well, is that one
on your? Oh, so it's like that. I got a picture.
Do you have a picture, Josh?
No, I don't know what to do. Is that right?
Yes, okay. Can you draw the picture here?
No, yeah, that's a good start.
I'm not with the chalk.
I don't know,
I
didn't check. Oh, no, she's in
Yeah, Josh started with a picture. You can start labeling the picture now. Label the picture. What again? What equation?
Y and X.
Professor, it's Thursday.
Where do you use the A and the B?
A is on the X axis.
A is the X and B is the Y, right?
Yeah.
So should we turn on some light now or not?
Yeah.
So you read it already, right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, who is it?
So you drew this. A, negative A, right? B, negative B. And this is your ellipse. I don't know how to draw it nicely. And then you inscribe a rectangle, right? And you want the rectangle to be what?
Excuse me. Actually, how do you think you know if ellipse is back or not?
It doesn't matter. It won't matter. Right?
Wait, what's the question?
You can make it standing up or lying down. It won't matter. The A is always going to be bigger, and you can put it on the Y axis. It's okay too. Alright? In this case, it won't really matter because you can have a lying down rectangle or a standing up rectangle and the area will be the same. Right? Okay? So therefore, since the center is at the origin, we can probably look at the general equation of this ellipse, right? What's the equation for this ellipse from yesterday?
X squared
over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. Okay? Then tell me what else I need to do. I want to maximize what?
Area.
Maximize the area of the rectangle. So in order to maximize the area, we need to talk about the dimensions, right, of the rectangle. So what dimensions do I need?
Length and width.
The length and the width, right? So the length is this, the width is this, but notice, of course, my graph is wrong, right? These four parts are really what?
Equal,
right? So since they're all equal, we might as well just look at what?
One fourth,
right? Okay? We can just look at 1/4 of it and just multiply by 4 to get it, okay? Now, the length of this quarter rectangle is what? Do we know what it is? No, right? We do not know. It's in general what?
4.
What is it? Instead of using L and W, you can use what? This is really X, and that's Y, right? The horizontal distance is X, the vertical is Y, okay? So therefore, you'll have XY here as your point, right? Okay? So the area of the rectangle that we want is given by what? Area is what? 4XY. So far, so good? Now the problem is we're only in calculus 2, we don't know calculus 3 yet.
Thank God.
So what does that mean? What did that statement mean from me?
You need another equation.
We need to kick out. Right now this area is really a function of how many variables?
Two.
We can
take out one variable.
Can do this in calc 3 but not in calc 2, right? So we need to kick out one variable. How do we kick out one variable?
Can we set it 1 to 0 or something?
You have to find the relationship between X and Y, right? And I'm claiming that the relationship is sitting right here, staring at you. Where is the
relationship?
The relationship between X and Y is here, right? Okay, so do you want to kick out X or Y?
Y.
Kick out Y, right? Okay, so if we kick out Y, what do we get? So can I tap down now?
Professor, can I ask a stupid question?
So we're there right now, right? Yeah.
How'd you get 4xy of the area? What area are you looking at?
We're looking at the quarter first, right? So that's length times width or whatever.
X, X, Y.
Uh-huh. X, Y, but then there are four of them.
But there are two Ys.
No, there are four of them.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Dude,
see, it was a stupid
you're
question.
Thinking way too hard. You have four rectangles. They're supposedly the same size, but of course
I'm sorry.
Drawing is bad, okay? I don't know if I did a better job on my thing. But yeah, so here I have that, okay? Which I don't know.
It's still a little
off, right? Okay, so it's okay.
It's just an optical illusion.
So then you want that, maximize the area, and then the next thing is to express this in terms of one variable, let's say x, right? And I think that's just algebra, so let's not waste time on that. So do you guys see that, right? So all I did was isolate the y, got this, okay? So far okay, right? So then now the function becomes a of x, so what will the form of the function be? It will be 4 b over a, right? X times the square root of a squared minus x squared. You guys understand? Mm-hmm. Okay? So you just substitute that. I just chose the positive y because, yeah, you can just choose the first quadrant thing, right? Okay? So you have this, and all you have to do is what? Oh, it says already.
Differentiate the root.
Why do we differentiate with respect to x? WRT is with respect to. I know word. Okay. And word complaint, right? So you know how to differentiate. Should we waste time differentiating or just give the answer?
Just for now.
You can do it, right? It's a product, right? Okay. And what I mean by waste time is, can we just look at the answer here? Okay. Instead of writing it out and struggling. Okay. So when I differentiated, I got this using the product rule, okay? You can do that at home, right? And figure that out. And then you get 2x squared equals a squared. So you get the answers, x is a over square root of 2, y equals b over square root of 2. Okay? And all you have to do is what? Plug those in. Those are your a and b. Why do I have twos? So the dimensions are 2a over square root of 2 by 2b over square root of 2. Where did the 2 come from? Well, to answer the final question, what are the dimensions of the rectangle? So you really need twice of x, right? And twice of y. You understand? So these are typical things you might encounter for your next test. Okay, so we have to kind of review our calc 1, okay, a little bit, okay? You also have to compare this with the endpoints, but the endpoints won't give you anything, right? Because if you plug in a, you will get 0, right? Okay, so that's how you do it. Okay, so that was the warm-up for
Ellipses. Wait, can you come back?